Now to a Fios One exclusive. 1 month after we reported the disappearance of Andrew Jarczyk, his body was found in the Hudson River.
The 27-year-old was last seen running along the waterfront. Tonight, his family is now planning a funeral. Fios One's Lee Shep joins us now live from Hoboken tonight with an exclusive interview with Andrew's family. Lee.
Certainly a heartbreaking ending. This is a man who loved life, loved dressing up in crazy costumes for Halloween and for other parties. But after a month-long search, Andrew Jarczyk's body was found here in Hoboken in the Hudson River. While the family still does not know how he wound up in the water, they say tonight at least they have some closure. His face was plastered all over Hoboken and North Jersey for a month. From utility poles to billboards, friends and family's lives turned upside down, wondering what happened to Andrew Jarczyk.
The longest month of my entire life. There's just nothing. No one can ever really understand what it's like to be stuck in suspended animation, just waiting.
It's been very painful. You know, every day we have the same conversations. We try to live our life, try to, you know, go back to work.
The 27-year-old from Hoboken was a man family say who would take his shirt off his back for anyone. He graduated from Susquehanna University and climbed the corporate ladder at PNC Bank in Woodcliff Lake. He was a son, an uncle, a boyfriend, Corinne Jarczyk's brother-in-law.
He's just a fun-loving person. He's was always joking, always happy, like always. Just he wasn't a person that, you know, was ever negative about things. He was very, very positive. I'm very excited about life.
But he loved Ohio State. He loved the Giants.
On March 30th, Hoboken police say Andrew had been out with friends when he decided to go for a run along the waterfront. He hadn't been seen or heard from since, until now. This week, exactly 1 month after his disappearance, Andrew's body was spotted by a ferry captain floating in the Hudson River near the Lackawanna train station. The medical examiner's office verified it was him using dental records. An autopsy report shows no sign of foul play. It's still unclear how he wound up in the water.
I don't believe we'll ever get the answers to those questions. We just try to focus on the fact that we are able to lay him at rest.
Painful goodbye, but Andrew's brother, Stephen, tells me now the grieving process can begin.
We can start to stay together and move forward. We're not going to forget him. Nothing will ever be the same, but we're able to know that he's safe now, so that we can have these memories and cherish them forever.
Andrew's wake is being planned for Sunday, his funeral on Monday. We are live in Hoboken tonight. Lee Sheps, Fios One News.